Hi everybody, I was just thinking, on my way home, came to watch my son's cricket match and then I'll stop at my other son at the university and I'm going to have lunch with him, then I'm going to be on my way home, just getting everything ready for the service for tomorrow and I was just thinking of challenging you with this that's in my mind. You know, if I look at what God has come and brought us in Jesus, and if we look at my own life in the last 20 years, how the doctrine, let me put it this way, since I got into grace, the major doctrine change that came to my heart was to move away from the penalty substitution system, right into understanding Christ as the one that came to conquer sin and death. Now, other than that, I wouldn't see, you know, I don't see major doctrinal changes, but I see a great development in of truth, the development of God's love. Well, the right word would be a better understanding of that. And you know, I would like to challenge you to never get to a place you feel you've known the love of God, you've known it all, and nothing can ever be understood in a better way. You know, that keeps people in a place where we cannot really see the depth of love of God. And I've got a scripture that I want to share with you as pertaining to that. You know, if you look at the scripture where Paul comes, and I've mentioned this in this week, and also last Sunday I spoke about that. The scripture states, and Paul comes, and he speaks to people in Ephesus, and he says, I've heard of your faith, and I've heard of your love for the saints, but I am praying that you may have your understanding enlightened. So that means that if you're a believer in Jesus and you've come to the faith and you believe that Jesus died for your sin and that kind of a thing, Paul says, I want you to still understand the hope of the calling. I still want you to understand the greatness of the love of God. I want you to understand that. I want you to understand why he grabbed a hold of you. You know, that is what I want you to understand. So I want to say to you, and I want to challenge you, never get to a place where you feel, you know, I've known it all. You know, I know everything. And the doctrine of this church is so perfect that we cannot understand anything in a better way. There's much to be understood. And I want to say what I've done in my life, and if I can just give some advice, not that maybe you even asked for it, but advice that I want to give is, whenever I go to the Lord, I say, Lord, and especially to preachers, I say, Lord, my heart number one is never to mislead anybody. We don't want to mislead anybody. Number two, we want to know your truth. It doesn't matter what it is. We want to know your truth in the light of the finished work of Jesus Christ. We want to know your truth inside the love of God, inside the goodness of God. We want to know that, and we want that with all our heart and nothing else. And we don't do that from a perspective of we don't have truth. We do it from a perspective of the truth is inside us, and God will elaborate and make us understand the dimensions of the love of God wherein we already stand. Now that's what he says. I pray that you may understand how high, how wide, how deep, and how long the love of God is, wherein we are. We are in that love. We are grounded in that love. But we want to understand what we are grounded in. Why? That we might be filled with the fullness of God. So I want to say to you that from Dynamic Love Ministries, you're going to hear messages that's going to challenge you. It has challenged me, but the great thing that I see about those messages is the peaceable fruit of righteousness that is producing in my life. So glory to God. I just wanted to encourage you with that, and I love you guys. You guys are just awesome. God bless.